Blessed be the one holy and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you have given to us, your servants, grace by the confession of a true faith to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity and in the power of your divine majesty to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in this faith and worship, and bring us at last to see you in your one and eternal glory, O Father, who with the Son and the Holy Spirit live and reign, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
One called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy, the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The pivots on the threshold shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" And I said, "Here am I, send me." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in the reading of the psalm. Ascribe to God, you heavenly beings.
Ascribe to God glory and strength. Ascribe due honor to God's holy name. Worship the Most High in the beauty of holiness. The voice of God is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. God is upon the mighty waters. The voice of God is a powerful voice. The voice of God is a voice of splendor. The voice of God breaks the cedar trees. God breaks the cedars of Lebanon. God makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Mount Hermon like a young wild ox. The voice of God splits the flames of fire. The voice of God shakes the wilderness. God shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of God makes oak trees thrive and strips the forest bare. And in the temple of the Holy One, all are crying glory. God sits enthroned above the flood, enthroned as sovereign forevermore. God shall give strength to the people. God shall give the people the blessing of peace.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God. Jesus answered him, very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above. Nicodemus said to him, how can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I have said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows wherever it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus said to him, how can these things be? Jesus answered him, are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know, and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things, and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one is ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
We had a blessed occurrence in our household. we had a baby boy.
Oh.
A grandson. And so, you know, Nan's up in Alaska now with the grandson. And the way it went was, you know, they live in this tiny little city of Skagway, so they had to, and they can't have a baby in Skagway, there's not facilities for it, so they have to go to Juneau. So they've been down in Juneau, Holly and Eric, waiting for the baby for about 3 weeks or so. Nan's been up there for a couple of weeks, and everything went, you know, they moved into this dormitory next to the hospital. You know, on the right day they decided it was time to have that baby, and he was born, and he was 9 pounds, 8 ounces. He was, you know, right exactly on the due date, and, you know, just exactly kind of the way things were supposed to go. That's how it happened. Now, his older sister, who's 6, Iris, it was a complete opposite. Holly went into labor way, way, way early, and they flew a Coast Guard airplane to Skagway and picked her up and the baby and flew them to Juneau, and it was too tough of a situation for the Juneau hospital, so they flew her to Ketchikan. ICU, neonatal ICU jet down to pick them up, a Learjet, and take them all the way up to Anchorage. And the baby was born in the ICU, and up to the Anchorage, like 5 weeks early, 5.5 pounds she weighed. So, 2 totally and utterly different birth journeys. Right? You know, it was, you thought the second one might go like the first one? No. So, it's going to be, it's just going to be a completely different thing. Well, that's really, and that's the story of all of us. You know, everybody has their own birth journey. It's like, no matter how many babies you have, the next birth is maybe going to be something completely different in terms of how it goes, how it unfolds and so on. So, and the same thing is true in terms of what Jesus was talking about here, about being born again, or about a spiritual rebirth. All of us go through spiritual rebirth differently. We might worship in the same place, and we might get together every Sunday, and you know, things like that, but in terms of our own individual spiritual birth or rebirth, and I think that's kind of a continuous thing, it's very, very individual. So for some of us, it may go pretty much the way it's supposed to, and we go to the church when we were a kid, and we, you know, get married when we're young, and we started to go to church, and we raised the kids in the church, and you know, it's sort of like just the way it's supposed to work. And for others of us, it might be more like flying all over Alaska, you know, and you know, hitting these touch points and finally landing somewhere, you know. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. There's no proper way to do that. And sometimes evangelical type churches will make this a litmus test. Are you born again? You know. And when they ask you that question, why, there's something they're looking for. You know, it's a certain thing you've done, you know, whether it was speaking in tongues, or whether it was, you know, who knows, it's different, you know, from different churches and so on, but it's not really like that. Yes, we all get born. Every one of us gets born, but we all get born differently. And we all get born spiritually, but we get born and reborn and so on. Different life experiences really impact that and affect it. But the main thing is that it's all good because it's leading to that baby, you know, it's leading to life. It's leading to new life. So it doesn't really matter how the journey goes or if it unfolds the way it's supposed to or if we have to have a C-section at the last minute, we didn't really want to, but whatever, because you know what, there's still this pain, there's still, that's what, that, you know, it's all about. And there's still the birth of something that moves us forward in our lives. So that's the really good news of this particular gospel, that we're in this continuous process of sort of restoring our spirituality and reinventing and reigniting it. And certain outside experiences, things like pandemics and so on, cause us to navigate our spiritual life in new ways that hopefully give us new insights and revelations and ideas of ways that we can use it. So we'll embrace this element of all of our individual spiritual journeys and give thanks to God that we're at least able to all do it side by side, you know, as part of the same community. Same thing. Amen.
Amen.
We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, came from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he came incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again
according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will never end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Father, Mother God, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all the people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, especially Richard, Ted, Jim, Marie, William, Jack, Lori, Christina, Nina, Dan, Allison, Anne, Laura Lee, Ron, Joan, Larry, Amara, Mai, Joyce, and Len.
They may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest. We pray especially for Curtis Swenson.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We pray for you. We pray, praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people and the multitude of your mercies. Look with compassion upon us and will all return to you for help. For you are gracious, a lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins to God.
God of all mercy,
we confess that we have sinned against you, both in the Lord and in our lives. We have denied your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that enslaves us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love and serve only your will. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Amen. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you.
What?
And we'll distribute the bread, the wafers, when it comes time. We are going to be eventually moving toward sending communion home and laying with the sick visitors, which is a great thing. Things continue to evolve as we kind of figure our way through this time. So we'll now turn our attention to these. walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For with your co-eternal Son and Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, in trinity of persons and in unity of being, and we celebrate the one and equal glory of you, O Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, the calling of Israel to be your people, your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. The night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he'd given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. We offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ, the blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with you and all the saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be to our Holy Father, now and forever.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
God for the people of God.
Amen.
together, let us pray.
Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. You have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you today and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Amen.
This week we've got book club Tuesday night. We have First Wednesday Connect this Wednesday. It's every first Wednesday of the month we do something. We've been connecting by Zoom on that night. This week we're going to meet right here. Bring a chair. We will have extra chairs. Bring a little snack. Beverage. We'll gather just to be together. No program other than just enjoying each other's company. What am I forgetting? Anything else? Well, you wore your parkas and your mittens. Who knows what Sunday will bring, but we're going to gather here every Sunday. And we really kind of lucked out this morning, so thanks for being here and being game to be the people of Christ at St. David's, who worship in all sorts of weather. So thank you for being here. All right? The gospel or the dismissal.
Lord, peace, love, and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.